Hi, this is JP from Nautilus of Arkham. This time I will be trying out Doctor Strange in leadership aspect against the Crossbones on expert difficulty. As an added difficulty level, I've changed the Hydra Assault modular set to the Master of Time modular set from the Kang scenario pack. So we are seeing maybe Kang also appear in this playthrough. So let's first look at Doctor Strange's deck. As usual, because it's a leadership deck, there are a lot of ally cards in the deck. I've added a lot of the ally cards that came with the Rise of Red Skull expansion. There is Black Knight. Also, there is Goliath. And other than that, we have the old staple allies like Falcon from the Captain America pack. Also, Wonder Man from Captain America. Then there are Hawkeye and Maria Hill. And of course, Wong, that is from Doctor Strange's signature cards. I've built the deck to revolve around either boosting one of the allies or especially boosting Goliath for one turn to hit multiple times hard. So I have the Inspiring Presences three copies in the deck. And also I have the boost staples lead from the front, Inspired from the upgrades, and of course the event Get Ready. So with those I will buff up one of the allies to hit multiple times a turn, and of course Dr. Strange can dish out a lot of damage with his invocation card, so there is that. But so that is basically the deck. I'll of course post the deck list in the video description so you can check it out. So let's get into the scenario. So we are playing Doctor Strange in leadership aspect against Crossbones, and because we are starting on phase 2, we already have the Crossbones machine gun in play. The last thing I need to do is to flip this card, and when revealed we put one of the experimental weapons deck cards into play. So we shuffle them and we get energy shield, so it gives retaliate to Crossbones. And that is that, so we are ready to start playing, so let's get started. I have pre-shuffled the deck, so yeah, let's be in Alter Ego. So let's get our opening hand of 6 cards. So we get the Mystical Studies, not that useful. Okay, we get 2 double resources. I think I'm mulliganing all of these cards, and we're hoping to hit something to play with those resources. Okay, well, we get the Avengers Mansion, Queen Carrier, Magic Blast, and Magic Enhancements. I think we are starting the game just building up. So first thing we'll do is we'll pay these 2 for the Avengers Mansion. Let's draw a card with the mansion. We get Astral Projection. And I'll think I'll just spend these 3 as resources to play Queen Carrier. And we will flip. And I'm just thinking, So let's just get rid of this. So we'll spend the resource, exhaust Doctor Strange, and we'll confuse the villain. And we remove 4 threat from a scheme, but there are no schemes in place, so this gets discarded. It's a bit crowded with the invocation deck, so let's shuffle this around. So the next card is the Vapors of Valdor. So the Vapors lets us change status card, so we could basically play that next turn to change the confusion to a stun or something like that. Well, let's see what happens next round. So we ready up. We draw back up to 5. We get Master of Mystic Arts, Maria Hill, lead from the front, Magic Blast and Black Knight. Okay, so hopefully we are getting some allies into play next round. Let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat here. Crossbone attacks. I think I will... I'll just take the damage for now. So we get 2 plus... Oh yeah, wrong deck. 2 plus... give the villain a tough status card. Okay, so I think we are changing that into a stun. So we get 2 damage. And we'll flip this cool double-sided by the same token ammo token for crossbones. So we spend 1 ammo from the crossbones machine gun and we'll deal 1 indirect damage. And that is the attack. We get an encounter card and it is Hard as Nails. Give the villain a tough... if you cannot heal 3 damage instead, well... That didn't do anything. Okay, well... That was an easy villain turn. Let's go to the next hero phase. First thing we'll do is draw a card with the mansion. We get a protective ward. Not that useful at the moment. I think we are... using the Queen Carrier to play. Actually, let's use Doctor Strange to play Vapors of Valdor. So we'll change this tough status card into a stunned. Let's see what we get next. We get the Crimson Band Sutorax. So I think I will pay for the Master of Mystic Arts to play this from the top of the invocation deck. I'll spend protective ward and I think lead from the front plate. We'll deal because the enemy is already stunned, we can't stun it again, but we'll deal 7 damage. And this is not an attack, so we don't take to retaliate. So just change this. Then, I think I'll play Maria Hill. I draw a card. Well, I get Genius. Unfortunately, nothing to play with the Genius. I'll just work here. Okay, that is the hero phase. We ready up. Draw back up to 5. We get Wong, Wonder Man, Rapid Response, Master of Mystic Arts, and Genius. The villain phase starts. We add a threat here. Crossbones tries to attack, is stunned. Encounter card is Madame Hydra. Okay, I think we are getting rid of Madame Hydra next turn. And that is the villain phase, so we'll go to the next hero phase. Let's start by drawing a card. We get Hawkeye. And I think Doctor Strange will use Genius to play Crimson Bands, or do I want to? Yeah, I'll play the Crimson Bands, so we defeat Madame Hydra. And actually, let's back up. I forgot I have this in hand, so I'll use this to play Master of Mystic Arts to defeat Madame Hydra. Then I will spend Hawkeye and Rapid Response, and then stun Crossbones and deal 7 damage. And Crossbones flips to phase 3. So we flip the top card of the experimental weapons. So power gauntlets attached to the villain, forced response after the attached villain attacks and damages you, discard one card from your hand. And we can get rid of this by spending a mental and a physical resource. Oh yeah, and the energy shield we can get rid of by spending energy and a mental resource. Okay. Okay. And let's see. We don't have anything to play these with, so I'll just... I think I won't do anything else. I think I'm discarding Wonder Man. We are drawing back up to 5. Okay, so we have Inspiring Presence, Falcon Get Ready, Inspired, and Wong. So we add a threat here. Crossbones is still stunned, so we remove the stun. Encounter card is Hydra sidearm. Attached to the villain, forced interrupt when attached villain attacks. The attack gains ranged plus one attack. Hero action, spend mental and physical resource, discard this card. So Crossbones has all the weapons he needs, but is constantly stunned, so can't actually attack us. So Crossbone has 16 health. We forgot to add those. So that was the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Let's see here. I'll draw a card. I get the power of leadership. That is really helpful. So let's see which ally would we want to play. I could play Wong. But that is not that useful. We could play Falcon. I think I'll remove the retaliate now. So we need to spend a mental and an energy. I'll use the power of leadership and Wing Carrier to discard that. So we don't take retaliates now. I think I'll play Wong and shuffle this, and I play the Wind of Atum. Okay, so we have the Crimson Bands for next turn, and draw 3 cards with the Wind of Atum. We get Hulk of Levitation, Goliath and Teamwork. Actually, I think I'll discard Teamwork and Falcon or use them to play the Cloak. I'll use the Cloak to ready. And then I will thwart for 2. And I'll flip. And Maria Hill just stands there. So, I think that is our turn. We ready up. We draw back up to 6. We have the Sanctum Sanctorum, lead from the front, power of leadership, inspiring present, times 2, and Goliath. So, let's go to the villain phase. We add a threat here. Crossbones is confused, we remove the confused, and the encounter card is combat knife. So, plus 1 attack. That's villain attacks against piercing, so yeah, Crossbones is armed to the teeth, but can't attack. So that is the villain phase. Let's go to the next hero phase. Okay, I think we are pretty close to defeating Crossbones either this turn or next turn, so let's draw a card. We get a protective ward, not that helpful. I think I'm flipping back. Then we are definitely playing the lead from the front, so each character that play controls gets plus 1 attack and plus 1 ward. Just put it here so I remember. Then I am definitely playing the Crimson Bands. So we stun Crossbones and deal 7 damage. Then we'll use the Cloak of Levitation, so be ready Doctor Strange. And I think I'm just hitting with Doctor Strange for 2 damage. Then Maria Hill hits for 2 damage. Then I think we are finishing the game with Wong, so Wong hits for 3 damage. And we'll play Inspiring Presence. We heal and ready Wong, and Wong hits for another 3 damage. So that is the game, a pretty easy one. Well, Doctor Strange with the leadership aspect is quite a strong hero to play, and even as Crossbones can be hard, I think that Crossbones is no match for Doctor Strange. So I hope you still like this playthrough, even if it was a quick and easy one. For once, it was easy. I have been struggling with some of the games lately, but nice to have an easy game now and then. We didn't see Kang, the Master of Time. I think it would have changed the game a lot if we would have gotten some harder encounter cards. But yeah, thanks for watching, and until next time.